Tesa the First Royal University ekubirizo kugoberera magezi gaba sawo bwetuba bakuyita mu mbeera eno obulungi ssettendekero ejjukiza abayizi n'abazadde nti ewandiika abagala okujeegattako mu lusoma olutandika mu August osobola okugenda ku mutimbagano ku kibanja kya www.mru.ac.ug okumanya ebikisomesa ebyenjawulo awamu n'ebisale so ng'era osobola okujja ku kitebe kyaffe ekikulu ekirumba Masaka oba ku ttabi lyaffe kakeeka Mengo okumanya ebisingawo osobola n'okuba ku masimu gano wammanga noti 75652 Nyamukaga 0 nenoti 754 munane mwemu 3 mukaga 8 nenoti 772 munana musambu mukaga 3 musambu munana. This is the First Royal University.
You are most welcome to MRU TV. I'm by names of Teacher Bukenya Joseph, a teacher at Budo College and Vienna High School Kabowa, basically teaching history and Christian religious education. Today my major concern is in the history of East Africa, and I'm going to take you through the topic known as the Portuguese rule on the East African coast. I'm going to take you through this topic of the Portuguese rule. The paper, it is the paper code, it is 241/1, that is history of East Africa, and we are going to deal with the topic of the Portuguese rule on the East African coast between 1500 up to 1700. And we are going to look at the areas or the key areas which are examined as far as the Portuguese rule on the East African coast is concerned. We are going to start with the first area which is examined under Portuguese rule on the East African coast. These are the reasons. These are the reasons for the coming. Reasons for the coming of the Portuguese at the East African coast. Then the second area which we are going to look at. Other area which is examined as far as the Portuguese rule on the East African coast is concerned, we are going to look at the Portuguese conquest. The Portuguese conquest, which was between 1498 up to 1510. Then the third area which is examined still under the Portuguese rule after the conquest, after the Portuguese conquering the East African coast, we are going to look at how they administered the East African coast. Now the third area, it means that it is the administration, the Portuguese administration. The Portuguese administration at the East African coast. Now, the fourth area still, after the administration, we shall look at the problems. Problems faced by the Portuguese at the East African coast. Then area five, which is examined still under the Portuguese rule, we are going to look at factors for the collapse. Factors for the collapse of the Portuguese rule. Then the last area, it is the effects. Effects or results of the Portuguese rule. Now today, we are going to deal with the Portuguese rule on the East African coast, and we are going to analyze the first area we are going to analyze, or the first part, we are going to analyze reasons for the coming of the Portuguese on the East African coast. That is one. Then second, we are going to look at the conquest. Oh, how did the Portuguese gain control of the East African coast between this year, that is 1498 up to 1510? Then after the conquest, after the Portuguese conquering the East African coast, now we are going to concentrate on the administration, how the Portuguese administered the East African coast. Then fourth area, automatically the problems faced by the Portuguese. Then another area, factors for the collapse of the Portuguese rule. Or why the Portuguese, they can set a question and say, why the Portuguese lost control of the East African coast. Then the last part, these are the effects of the Portuguese rule at the East African coast. Now, let us start with our first area. Those are the reasons for the coming of the Portuguese at the East African coast. This is our first part, reasons for the coming of the Portuguese at the East African coast. But before I give you the reasons for the coming of the Portuguese at the East African coast, let me give you a brief background. That is what we call an introduction. Remember, in history, an introduction is a must. And failure by a candidate to give an introduction, you lose out a mark. So a candidate, before you answer any question about the Portuguese, let's say they can set a question and say, why were the Portuguese interested in the East African coast? Why were the Portuguese interested in the East African coast? Before you give those reasons why the Portuguese were interested in the East African coast, you have to first give the introduction, the brief background about the Portuguese. Who were the Portuguese? Where did they come from? So in the introduction, I'm interested in a candidate to give more, to enlighten more about the Portuguese before you give me these reasons for their coming. So in our introduction, you can say that the Portuguese were the first group of Europeans. The Portuguese were the first Europeans to come and settle at the East African coast. First group of Europeans to come and settle at the East African coast. They came from a country known as Portugal. You hear the word Portuguese, meaning that they came from a country known as Portugal. So proceed and again tell the examiner the year they came at the East African coast, between 1500 up to 1700. Or another candidate can say that around the 15th century, the Portuguese came at the East African coast around the 15th century. So that is our simple introduction as far as the Portuguese are concerned. Now we are going to deal with the reasons which attracted the Portuguese to come and settle at the East African coast, or in the East African coast. So they can set a question and say, why were the Portuguese interested in the East African coast? Meaning that a candidate is supposed to give the reasons for their coming. So the reasons for the coming of the Portuguese, basically, we are going to look at what attracted them to settle at the East African coast. One, a candidate can talk about hospitality. That the Portuguese came at the East African coast because they were highly welcomed by the coastal people. Then another factor, you can talk about the strategic location, that the East African coast was strategically located, therefore also attracted the Portuguese to come at the East African coast. You can also talk about the good natural harbors, where their ships could easily anchor, also attracted the Portuguese to come at the East African coast. Then you can also talk about the presence of highly demanded goods. For example, slaves, presence of highly demanded goods also attracted them to come at the East African coast. Then you give the examples of these highly demanded goods. For example, slaves, ivory, copper, gold, among others. Then you also talk about the profitable trade which was going on at the East African coast. That was the coastal trade, or the Indian Ocean trade, also attracted the Portuguese to come and settle at the East African coast. Then you talk about other factors like love for adventure, that the Portuguese also came at the East African coast simply because they wanted to explore or to know what was taking place in East Africa. Then still, you can also talk about fertile soils, on the East African coast. Then you talk about the importance of those fertile soils, presence of fertile soils at the East African coast, which were favorable for agriculture, also attracted the Portuguese to come and settle at the East African coast. Then you talk about Christianity. See, being Christians, the Portuguese were Christians. So being Christians, they came at East African coast to spread the word of God, or to spread Christianity. Then the Portuguese were also looking for the direct route to India. They were looking for the direct route to India. That's why they settled at the East African coast. Now, those are the sum of the reasons for the coming of the Portuguese at the East African coast. Oh, why they can raise a question. An examiner can set a question and say, why were the Portuguese interested in the East African cost, you give these factors: strategic location, good climate, fertile soils, fresh drinking water, among others. Now, let us proceed to the second area, which is examined as far as the Portuguese rule on the East African coast is concerned. The second area, we are done with the first part. That is the reasons for the coming of the Portuguese. Now, I'm going to take you through the part which is very crucial and dynamic. I'm going to take you the part. This part is very crucial and it is very dynamic. This part is very crucial and dynamic. So candidates should concentrate as far as this part is concerned, because it is very important and it is very dynamic and it disturbs students. So I'm going to emphasize, or I'm going to make more emphasis as far as the Portuguese conquest is concerned, this part is very crucial and it is very dynamic and it is examined. So the Portuguese conquest, some students think that the Portuguese conquest is very difficult, yet it is the cheapest and the simplest of all. I'm going to give you the techniques of giving the, or writing the conquest of the Portuguese. Remember, when you are giving the conquest, or when you're writing the Portuguese conquest, you have to give the historical facts in their chronological order. When I talk about chronological order, I mean in their correct order. You have to give those years, because the Portuguese conquest starts from 1498 up to 1510. So a candidate should give these historical facts from 1498 in their order up to 1510. By the moment you miss out, you're meaning that you have already lost the marks. So you have to give these years, how the Portuguese conquered the East African coast from 1498 up to 1510. So here we need a chronology. You have to give the years in their chronological order from 1498 up to 1510. Now we start. And here, as far as the Portuguese conquest is concerned, they can set a question and say, how the Portuguese gained control of the East African coast? How the Portuguese gained control of the East African coast? They may not bring in, when it is dialect, that describe the Portuguese conquest. No. They may trick the question and say, how the Portuguese gained control of the East African coast between 1498 up to 1510. So a candidate, the question approach of that question, a candidate has to give or to write the Portuguese conquest, that process, how the Portuguese conquered the East African coast. Now I'm going to start by giving you the Portuguese conquest. The Portuguese conquest, we are going to start with the Vasco da Gama. That is in 14. I want to be very clear. We are going to start with the year. That is 1498. The year 1498. We start with Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama. Then in 14, you go ahead and tell the examiner that in 1498, Vasco da Gama made a survey on the East African coast. He arrived with the three ships and made a survey on behalf of King Emmanuel of Portugal. He was impressed with the strategic location of the East African coast, hospitality of the coastal people, then also the favorable climate, which could favor human settlement at the East African coast. So after he gave back good report to the King of Portugal, that is King Emmanuel, then in 1500, we are seeing Pedro, we are seeing Pedro Alvarez Quebro. In 1500, Pedro Alvarez Quebro made an unsuccessful attack on Sofara. Made an unsuccessful attack on Sofara and its gold trade. That is in 1500. Then, in 1502, We are seeing Vasco da Gama coming back. Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama. In 1502, we are seeing Vasco da Gama coming back. He made his second journey on the East African coast. This time round, Vasco da Gama arrived with 19 ships. Arrived with 19 ships, captured Kirwa and its gold trade. Also imprisoned the Sultan of Kirwa, that is Sultan Ibrahim. Sultan Ibrahim was imprisoned and was to be released after paying tribute to the King of Portugal. But Sultan Ibrahim failed to pay tribute to the King of Portugal. Then in 1503, we are seeing Ray Lawrence Ravasco in 1503. Ray Lawrence Ravasco came at the East African coast, conquered the towns of Zanzibar, he conquered Zanzibar and other small towns. That is in 1503. Then in 1504, we are seeing Lopez Suarez. That is in 1504. Lopez Suarez attacked Kirwa and disrupted its gold trade. But still, Sultan Ibrahim of Kirwa refused to pay tribute to the King of Portugal. Then in 1505, are you seeing the order, students? From 1498, then 1500, then 1502, then 1503, 1504, now I'm on 1505. So you have to give this conquest of the Portuguese in its chronological order. By the moment you fail to do so, no marks. So in 1505, we are seeing Francisco de Almeida. We are seeing Francisco de Almeida in 1505. For Francisco de Almeida came at the East African coast, attacked three towns. He started with Sofara, which surrendered without any struggle. Then he proceeded to Kirwa, which he routed and destroyed its architecture. Then he proceeded to Mombasa. Mombasa tried to put up some resistance against the Portuguese, but it was also defeated. Then in 1506, now I'm on 1506. From 1505, now it is 1506. In 1506, we are seeing Trieste da Cunha, that is in 1506. Trieste da Cunha captured the towns of Petit, Lemo, and were put under the Portuguese rule. Then I proceed in 1509. In 1509, we are seeing that more island districts were brought under the control of the Portuguese. For example, Pemba and Zanzibar were brought under the Portuguese rule in 1509. Then in 1510, the entire coastline of East Africa was under the control of the Portuguese rule. So that is the Portuguese conquest, students. Most of the students think that the Portuguese conquest is hard, yet it is the cheapest and the simplest of all. As long as you follow the chronological order, you get the whole marks. So that is it. That was the second area. The first part was all about the reasons for the coming of the Portuguese at the East African coast. Now, the second area, we have been looking at the Portuguese conquest, how the Portuguese gained control of the East African coast between the year 1498 up to the year 1510. So, allow me to go to the third area, which is examined as far as the topic of the Portuguese rule on the East African coast is concerned. Now, that area is also very important. That is the Portuguese administration. After conquering the East African coast, now we look at administration.
Jesa the First Royal University ekubirizo kugoberera magezi gaba sawo bwetuba bakuita mumbere no bulungi setendekine jukiza abayizi nabazadde nti wandika bagalo kujega tako mu lusomo lutandika mu August osobola kugenda ku mutimbagano ku kibanja kya www.mru.ac.ug okumanya bichisomesa ebyenjawulo awamu n'ebisale songero osobola kujja ku kitebe kyaffe ekikulu ekirumba Masaka oba kutabiri yaffe kakeka Mengo okumanya bisingawo osobola n'okuba ku masimu gano wammanga noti 75582 Nyamukaga 0 nenoti 75 munane mwemu 3 mukaga 8 nenoti 72 munana 75 3 78 Jesa the First Royal University lwe rutindo lwokubuwanguzi.